I regret that I got injured by a guy that couldn't wrestle and had has no business of being in a Hall of Fame. You know, he should be in the Hall of Shame. So many guys I would love to have worked with that are wrestling today. I'm very critical of the wrestling today, but not the wrestlers. I think the wrestlers are some of the as good as they've ever been, and maybe better than they've ever been. Better athletes. I would say that the negative to that is that everyone looks the same. They all walk the same. They all talk the same. They all have the same outfits. I like a little more of a mix and match, like. You know, like different shapes and size, like a King Kong Bundy and a, you know, 1-2-3 Kid, or like different shape. I like different kinds of wrestlers. Whereas I think when I look at wrestlers today, they all look like Chippendale dancers, and they all look very buff, and they all work out clearly every 10 minutes. And I don't know, I think they're a little bit too much cookie cutter. They all look the same, and I like the variety of wrestlers. But if I had to pick some of the young guys that I could work with today, I would love to have worked with, I think above and beyond everybody, I would love to work with CM Punk. Just, I thought he was to me the best sort of the guy that came along after me. He was really exceptional and really talented and really special. Daniel Bryan is another one. I would love to work with them. I think if I could have picked somebody to work with, say, back when I was a heel and saying all that stuff about America and all that stuff, who wouldn't love a Bret Hart John Cena match? I mean, it would have been such a Canada versus US kind of thing. It would have been such a beautiful, it's already a perfect story already made, you know, of wrestling a young American guy like when he first started. I would love to have had a chance to work with John Cena. And then you can go on and on. Like, I would love to work with Seth Rollins. I would love to work with Roman Reigns. I would love to work with, I'd love to have just taught these guys things. And, you know, everything in wrestling, I think, is about timing. And, you know, the timing is so critical to believability in wrestling matches. And I find wrestling today is just not very believable. It's just too unbelievable. Too many, you know, they drop the score clock on somebody from the ring and lands on him and he kicks out and then does a running spot in the ropes. And, you know, it just never doesn't quite seem real. Like a few years ago, like Kevin Nash slingshotted me backwards into a table and I crashed through the table. Everybody thought it was real. Like, no one saw it coming. It was right out of the blue. It wasn't like Sabu or anyone else. It was like totally different. And when he threw me in the ring, there was that sense of like, I don't know what's going to happen because I've never been in this situation before as a fan. I don't know if he's really hurt or... Anyway, that's the kind of stuff that's missing in wrestling today. And just the last thing I'll just say is that Chris Jericho's wrestling as good as he ever was and is, to me, proven that he's as durable and as good a champion today as he ever was. And I have a lot of respect for Chris for just being as good as he is and still passing on his legacy.
Do you ever think about if you hadn't had to retire when you did, do you think you would have been the kind of guy that in your kind of late 40s, you still have been going and you still been wrestling?
Hell yeah. I would have shit those guys in wrestled in Saudi Arabia and got paid $3 million each. Bill Goldberg, who kicked me in the head, never even thought about it. 8 months later, went over to Saudi Arabia, got paid $3 million for a 5 minutes wrestling match. And put all that money in his pocket, but never once thought about costing me $16 million when he kicked me in the head. And so, you know, I regret that I got injured by a guy that couldn't wrestle and has no business of being in a Hall of Fame. No, he should be in the Hall of Shame.
So Davey, when I saw him in the dressing room on the Saturday night, I was like, why did you call me? I've been trying to call you, and I was pretty mad at him. And he just, sometimes Davey was like a little brother or a little kid to me. And I remember he just confessed, he goes, I'm fucked. And he told me, he'd been up with Jim Neidhart for 72 hours. They'd been doing cocaine for 3 straight days and he hadn't slept.